Iowa was covered by glaciers until 15,000 years ago. These massive flowing sheets of ice would creep along like very slowly moving rivers, picking up lots of different minerals, rocks, soil, and debris along the way. As the glaciers melted, rocks and minerals got left behind. We call this glacial till. The water from the ice melt is the foundation of our many river valleys, as well as some of our lakes and wetlands. These rocks and minerals were slowly broken down by water and microorganisms to form new soil. Iowa's landscape gradually became covered in a vast prairie consisting of hundreds of species of grasses, flowers, birds, mammals, insects, and soil organisms. For thousands of years, the cycle of prairie plants growing, dying, and decaying formed a thick layer of rich topsoil. Iowa was one of the most biologically diverse ecosystems in the world. Also dotting the prairie were numerous wetlands or prairie potholes. Prairies and wetlands worked together to build rich, healthy soils, keep Iowa's water clean, and feed its inhabitants. In the 1800s, European settlers moved into Iowa. In order to feed their families, small sections of the prairie were slowly broken or turned over for planting crops and gardens while livestock grazed the prairie. Wetlands were drained so the fertile land could be farmed. With the invention of the steel moldboard plow in 1837, Iowa's landscape was rapidly transformed from one of the most diverse ecosystems in the world to one of the most altered landscapes. Today, less than 1% of Iowa's native prairies and 10% of its wetlands remain. For generations, farmers have turned over the rich black soil, plowing under corn stalks and plant residue after harvest. Without plant material to protect the land surface, this rich topsoil can easily blow away or get washed away into streams, rivers, or lakes. What takes the earth 500 to 1,000 years to make can be lost in 10 to 15 years. Farming right up to the edge of streams and rivers can leave the land vulnerable to stream bank erosion. So what can be done? Increasing no-till and strip-till farming leaves the majority of plant residue on the land to protect the soil from erosion so it doesn't pollute our water. Prairie and wetlands were part of our past and are a key to our future. We can plant small strips of prairie where they can best capture nutrients in soil before they reach streams. Prairie strips can reduce erosion by 90%. Reestablishing wetlands will help clean our water by removing sediment, nutrients, and chemicals. Wetlands have many important jobs to do. Beyond their beauty, prairies and wetlands provide habitat for mammals, birds, insects, and many other types of wildlife. If we are to leave the land in better shape for future generations, prairies, wetlands, and croplands must work together to nurture a diverse landscape, fertile soils, and clean waters.